Hey guys, welcome to another video. My name is GameCubert, and today we're looking at how you're going to root your Steam Deck. More on that after the intro. Okay, so you might be wondering, you might be thinking, hey, you're crazy. The Steam Deck is technically already rooted. It's a Linux system that you're gonna have root privileges on, so why would you need to root it? Well, that was a little bit of a lie. To be honest, what I was actually talking about is an operating system you can install on the Steam Deck that actually might be better than Deck OS. Now, this operating system is still kind of in its earlier stages. I know that a lot of people are probably going to be looking for something like this right when the actual device comes out, just so they can see what they can do with the hardware, but I'm gonna get to it first. So, na-na-na-boo-boo, stick your head in doo-doo. Chimera OS basically started back when the fall of Steam OS occurred. Chimera OS originally started as an operating system called Gamer OS. Essentially, Gamer OS was this wonderful operating system that was based on the Steam Big Picture Mode UI. And what that essentially meant was the entire thing looked like a Steam machine. But it had one amazing product installed on it that pretty much made the system, and that was Proton. See, SteamOS kind of just fell out of public view and got completely destroyed after it flopped for not being able to play most of the games that you'd want to play on it. And as a result, Valve kind of just ditched the project a little bit. They probably have, you know, ripped apart different parts of it to put it into Deck OS, but for the most part, this project was abandoned. So what does that mean for Chimera OS, and how is that related to Gamer OS? Well, Gamer OS actually was pretty unique because it did use that whole Steam Big Picture Mode UI, so it looked just like a Steam machine's GUI. The only difference was it could actually play games that were Windows games instead of just playing Linux ones. And again, this was in the early days of Proton though, so it kind of worked with varying degrees, but for the most part, you could get quite a few games to work on it, and it was much more useful than SteamOS. So, what happened? Why did it change its name to Chimera? Well, from what I can gather, I don't really know. I think they changed it generally to make it sound cooler, but when I go and look at some of their other stuff, they still have Gamer OS listed. So, I guess, you know, it could be called Gamer OS or Chimera OS, and they probably wouldn't care too much. Anyway, Chimera OS started out Arch-based, which is pretty ironic considering that Deck OS is also going to be Arch-based, so they have that commonality already set. From what I've read, the developer actually changed things so that way you can basically open up any of your games with just a controller and run the entire game using only a controller. Extra functions like typing to your friends and sending in chats and stuff like that will still require a keyboard, but this is pretty awesome. This is very helpful for people who want to just play like a console gamer would. And because it runs the Steam Big Picture Mode, you can pretty much navigate everything in this way. And what's awesome is, unlike a normal console where you're restricted to the controller that came with the console, or the controller that the console providers created, you actually can use any controller that you want, provided that it's a controller that's supported, I guess, in the Steam's list of controllers that you can use, which I don't even know if there really is a list of supported and unsupported. I think, generally speaking, Steam can run almost any controller, provided it connects through Bluetooth. But what's awesome about this is I could hook up a PS5 controller, an Xbox One controller. You know, the possibilities are endless. And with this, it's pretty awesome because there's actually inbuilt ROM support. See, the way that Chimera OS works is essentially your device that you install Chimera OS on has to be completely wiped. There will only be Chimera OS on it. You cannot install anything else. Chimera OS will be what's installed. And so what does this mean? Well, it generally means that you aren't gonna have a lot of dual booting options. You can't switch over from your computer to Chimera OS. It just doesn't work that way as of right now. At least you'd have to do a lot of work to try to get it to be able to do that, because the developers themselves don't make that as an instant option. It is open source though, and it is Linux, so there will probably be someone out there who can do it, but I'm not technical, so I'm not going to do that. Anyway, Chimera OS's ROM support is different from the support that exists currently on Steam, mostly because it was kind of developed beforehand. Essentially, you can send your ROMs into the device using your network. So essentially what you're doing is you're basically just using the address of your computer, and you're sending ROMs into the computer over that address. You can't even just manually move them in, because there's not an easy way for a controller to be able to do that. So instead, you just sort of upload them to your computer, which isn't difficult for games that are smaller, but if you wanted to try to put big game ROMs into there, I could see there being a bit of a struggle. As of right now, there's only so many systems that are supported with emulation, but to be honest, it's a pretty good start. If you like retro gaming, you're gonna have a nice little place to hang out with this device. It's basically very, very similar, if not almost the same as DeckOS, but better, because this thing actually supports different launchers games, like Epic Games and GOG games. Essentially, this thing is just a little bit better than DeckOS as we currently know things about it. Obviously, we don't know everything about DeckOS, that's kind of under wraps by Valve, but from what I can tell here, Valve is not going to provide you with an easy way to use the Epic Games Store or the good old games game store. So, you know, generally speaking, I think this device might just be able to eke out a little bit above what DeckOS might be able to provide, especially because it's based on the exact same type of Linux. So anything that Valve develops for DeckOS could probably be ported right onto this thing. Essentially, this is the rooted version of a Steam Deck, if you can even really call it that. All you're really doing is making it easier for yourself to do some of these things. In actuality, you could obviously do all of these things on the Steam Deck, it just might be a little bit more time consuming, and for people who don't want to waste their time, this is a nice option. But anyway, guys, that's gonna do it for this video. Short video, I know. If you liked the video, hit that like button. Subscribe. Also, I'm actually got a weird thing going on where I do affiliate marketing. Essentially, what that means is there's a link down in the description. If you click it and you go and buy the service, then I get a little bit of money. Also, that service might actually be interesting to you. If you like to learn things about YouTube or you want to become a YouTuber, it's a pretty useful little thing to read about. It's called TubeBuddy, and I hope that you enjoy their services. Goodbye!